You know something? I should release. Wait, what happened to my voice?
Plotagon received an update. It seems to remove custom pitches for voices.
Charlie and Harley will be quite surprised to hear themselves speak. I'll see what I can do to fix this.
Before you do that, I have something very important to say regarding YouTube. It affects every content creator.
Sounds very important. I should probably make a video on this conversation.
You may have noticed that there is a new option you can toggle when uploading a video.
The "Is this video made for kids?" option? I saw it, but I didn't pay attention to it, seeing as I make content that anyone can enjoy.
Alright. I'm saying this for your own good. You need to list all of your videos as made for kids.
How come? My videos were made with all ages in mind.
That's the thing. The FTC will see your videos as made for kids.
Remind me again. Who is the FTC, and what influence do they have over YouTube?
The FTC is a department in the American government in charge of enforcing child safety. YouTube was found in violation of COPPA, which states that children shall not be tracked and targeted by advertisements, and was fined a hefty sum of money.
Care to elaborate on this a little more?
Prior to the FTC's involvement, there was never an option to label a video as made for kids, so anyone watching any monetized video would receive targeted ads. Since anyone includes kids, they were also being targeted by ads, which is a violation of COPPA's policy. It is for this reason that the FTC fined YouTube, and as part of the agreement, YouTube included an option to let content creators mark their video as made for kids, so that it wouldn't receive targeted ads.
Then I should be fine, right? I don't monetize my videos.
I wouldn't be so sure. You shouldn't take such risks, especially not under threat of a large fine.
A fine, huh? How much are we talking?
The numbers aren't exact, but if you mark a children's video as not made for kids, you could be fined up to $42,000 per violating video.
That's way more money than what I make in 2 years. If I'm hit with one of those, I'll be ruined.
Of course, you could just list all of your videos as made for kids, to avoid the risk altogether.
That is the smart thing to do, since all of my videos are suitable for kids. Unfortunately, it's not that easy. What happened? Why do I sound like this? Blamed Plotagon update, and what do you mean by it's not that easy? Since this is about not putting targeted ads in front of children, videos listed as made for kids will not contain them, and therefore will generate less revenue. That's unfortunate. How much less is a video expected to make? According to Chatronic, DigiMike and MatPat, those videos are expected to receive up to 90% less ad revenue. Are you kidding me? I wish I could say that I was, but I'm not kidding. That's got to be worse than the adpocalypse. It gets worse. Since YouTube is also making less money off of children's content, YouTube would rather you watched videos not targeting children. As such, you won't be recommended those videos, and you can't even find them in search results. That's gonna stunt channel growth for sure. Surely that's the end of it. It can't get much worse, can it? It can definitely get worse. Try having your comment section disabled for every video targeting kids. Good grief. This nightmare has to end at some point. But there's still time. Nothing is set in stone yet. You mean there's still hope? Yes, everything I told you about the changes coming to the COPPA policy to impact YouTube is only a proposition at this point. If it's only a proposition, there must be a way to provide feedback on the subject matter. There is. The FTC was gracious enough to provide us with a public feedback page regarding the upcoming changes. Here, you can let the FTC know of the impact the proposed changes will have on YouTube. Please be civil. We'd rather establish ourselves as professionals voicing our concerns in constructive feedback, and not haters who would resort to insults. It is our hope that the FTC will listen to reason. It'll only help if they hear from professional-sounding people. I'm glad to hear that. So there is still time. This is a link to the feedback page for COPPA. Be sure to post it in the video description. I will. Thank you for sharing this. One more thing. A petition has been started on change.org. It is hoped that if enough people sign the petition, the FTC will take note of this and revise the proposed changes to COPPA. Here's the link to the petition. Again, thank you. There is a deadline. The FTC is only accepting feedback until December 9th. After this date, the updated policy will go through, and no further revisions will be accepted. So we must act quickly, huh? And even if the changes do go through, they won't take effect until New Year's.
Take that information with a grain of salt. Only one of the three videos I watched mentioned this information.
What are your thoughts on the topic? People need to know about the upcoming changes, more than ever. We don't want people going bankrupt over the new policies because they didn't know. If any of you out there make YouTube videos, by all means, make a video on the subject. If you know of someone who haven't made a video on COPPA, leave a comment on one of their videos. Everyone needs to know about this. Well said. Thank you for watching this video. If you'd like to leave a comment on this video, you can't. Fortunately, I made another video talking about the issue. You can leave a comment there. If you are interested in learning more about the COPPA policy, Chatronic, Biju Mike, and MatPat made some pretty good points. Those are the ones I watched, but there are others who made a video on the subject. Before I go, there's something I think YouTube can do here. YouTube, if you're watching this, you should ask viewers if they are a kid when they click on a video. If they claim not to be a kid, they should have to verify a security question to proceed. If they claim to be a kid, they can continue to watch the video, but have untargeted ads. An incentive could be a little more ads for kids to watch. This would put pressure off the people who can't control whether or not kids watch their content. And with that, I bid all of you farewell. Now, to figure out this voice issue.